March 14th, 2014. We are all ready to get to the fight that I have been looking forward to very, very much. Highly anticipated, I think, is the best way I can describe it, using proper English instead of not using proper English. So, this is going to be Saturday Series SmackDown number 3, the return of the Saturday Series SmackDown. Considering that we haven't done one in about 3 weeks, and the reason why that was is because, or maybe it was only 2 weeks. This is like week number 3 that, oh, anyway. The reason why we haven't had it in the past couple weekends was because last Saturday, of course, was the SS Radio Open number 5, and the previous Saturday before that was a Blizzard event. So, yeah, that pretty much meant that we are not going to be doing the Saturday Series SmackDown, but hey, that is all right because it is not going anywhere. Just had to take a brief vacation. We could all use one. So, today, this is how it's going to work. As always, for the Saturday Series SmackDown, I'm going to allow 3 minutes for voting to take place. And for those of you watching on YouTube, you can go click the link down below, and that would take you past the vote, go straight to the beginning segment of which one of these two titans of the YouTube series slash Twitch series are going to win. We've got, in this corner, spawning on the northwestern side of your title screen, it's going to be Super Amazing Wagon Adventure. Pretty much a staple in my Twitch community along with SS Radio, going up against the very, very popular YouTube series and also long-running, one of the longest-running series on the channel, and isn't that crazy, is Geoguessr with Sinvicta. I have been thoroughly waiting for this matchup to take place, so this is how it's going to work. The vote was cast in my live stream chat channel. So again, for those of you who are watching this on YouTube, you should come out and check out a live show because it's the only time you get to vote. I also make it a point to announce the upcoming next week's matchup on either Monday night or Tuesday night. It just depends. Usually in the past show it was Tuesday night. The previous show, the very first one, it was a Monday night. And again, I will be announcing the candidates for next Saturday's Saturday Series SmackDown showcase. That is going to be Monday or Tuesday of this week. Without further ado, I am not going to delay any longer just because of the fact that I really, really want to see how this one pans out. We are going to begin the vote. So, ladies and gentlemen, for those of you who are listening in Twitch chat, all you have to do is go to this straw poll, and I will be linking it in 3 seconds. Go vote. You only get one vote. And remember, if you are listening to this on YouTube, you are highly encouraged to come out and support your favorite series. Saturday is quickly going to become the most favorite day, I think, for most people who watch my series here on YouTube as well as on Twitch. So, for example, if you like Air Amazing, come out and find out when the next Air Amazing bout is going to be. Come here on Saturday evenings and vote for it. All Saturday Series SmackDowns will be taking place at 8 p.m. Central, 9 p.m. Eastern, and 6 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. So make sure if you see it go out on my Twitter, Facebook, or YouTube feed, get ready to vote. Without further delay, here we go, SSSS number 3. Seriously Live, here is the link. Good luck, have fun, everyone, and I am thoroughly looking forward to seeing which one of these two titans are going to win. Is it going to be Super Amazing Wagon Adventure, or is it going to be Geoguessr with Sinvicta? And again, I am going to allow 3 minutes of voting here in the live stream. And we shall see which one is going to win. Of course, Super Amazing Wagon Adventure has not really been a staple on YouTube. Because of the fact that it was, unless we have had a couple of episodes come up on YouTube just because they're hilarious, like when Tempo, my real life Bretta Tempo, was somehow inexplicably killed by a pelican. That one is now legendary status. But Super Amazing Wagon Adventure is a series that I have been doing before every single stream. I stopped doing it recently due to things that I won't get into. But it became a staple of every Tuesday and Thursday before and after every SS Radio. And it's been a staple of the Sinvicta community as well. And, of course, I'm good friends with Sparse Vector, the creator. Looking forward to the upcoming game, Go Plague Monkey Go. And in the other side of the spectrum, we've got Geoguessr with Sinvicta, which is one of the longest-running series on YouTube, period, for my channel. It's been going on since last year, early last year, and it's still going strong. I know I haven't put out any recent Geoguessr videos Since I think last week was the last one that came out with the 100 episode special. That's because I'm just giving it a rest before we bring it back for episode 101 and go on screaming towards episode 200. Wouldn't that be fun indeed? So the voting's still taking place right now. There's about 20 more seconds before the polls close. And again, if you are listening to this on YouTube, you want to make sure that you are coming out and supporting your favorite series in the Saturday Series SmackDown. So if you're really diehard Super Amazing Wagon Adventure fans and you want to see it go into an official episode here on YouTube, then you better get out here on Saturday because there's a lot of support for Geoguessr. Or, you know, you could see down the line, you could see Super Amazing Wagon Adventure versus, say, Friday Night Fan Fights. You could see Try Hard Thursday versus Geoguessr, etc. Saturdays are going to become everyone's favorite day of the week. It's certainly my favorite day of the week now because I love the Saturday Series SmackDown Showcase. It is a lot of fun. So with that, the polls are officially closed, and the winner, by not really a landslide, it's a lot closer than I think some people thought. It was 61% to 39%, but the winner, the official winner of the third Saturday Series SmackDown Showcase is going to be none other than Super Amazing Wagon Adventure. Congratulations, all you Wagon Adventure fans out there. You have earned the right to have three episodes of Super Amazing Wagon Adventure appear on YouTube. And again, for those of you who are disappointed that Geoguessr did not get picked, and you are watching this on YouTube, hey, I let everyone know early on in the week when the votes are taking place, and we voted it off, and it's going to be Super Amazing Wagon Adventure. Very awesome indeed. And again, congratulations to S.A.W.A. Thank you, everyone who voted here on the Twitch chat. And for those of you watching on YouTube, thank you for sticking around. Hope you enjoy three back-to-back episodes of Super Amazing Wagon Adventure. Ooh, let us get started. I will mention that this is not going to go on these episodes will not count on the official Wagon Adventure document because we no longer are keeping up to date with that for now. It's possible that will be back, but these are just going to be for funsies, and I'm going to be taking three different people for three episodes. If you've never seen this game, then stick around because you're going to enjoy it. So the winner of the third ever Saturday Series SmackDown Showcase is Super Amazing Wagon Adventure, which won by 61% to 39%. So congratulations to Super Amazing Wagon Adventure. So here's how it's going to work. I'm going to take names from the Twitch chat, priority will go to Twitch TV subscribers and the non-subs. So if you'd like to play, and if you are inside of the Twitch chat right now, please type a one only once, and I will get it going. Actually, I'm going to have everyone, I want everyone to type in S.A.W.A, S-A-W-A, if you want consideration. Because I already saw some people typing ones prematurely. So if you would like to get consideration for the Wagon Adventure, type S.A.W.A, S-A-W-A. It doesn't have to be in caps. You can put it in all caps if you want. And again, priority will go to subscribers than non-subs. So it looks like for the first run, it's going to be Berserker, who's someone who has been on the Wagon Adventure before. And he's got brown hair. Second member of the mosh pit that I saw was Hyena Bones. Hyena Bones. And she has... I don't want her to yell at me. So I'm gonna do this right. I hope, anyway. We're gonna give her Ugu eyes. There you go. And a pink dress. Goes. And last but not least, on the first adventure, the third is going to be Panda Breaker, member of the Mosh Pit here. I am gonna be changing up the I will be changing up the saying for everyone. Let's put it that way. For each episode, or each run, I should say, because it's all gonna be one episode. So here we are with run number one. It's going to be Berserker Wagoneering. Also going to be in the middle seat. It's going to be Hyena Bones, who says that she will not yell at me. And last but not least, we also have Panda Breaker. Of course, this is a Super Amazing Wagon Adventure. If you have seen this game before, keep in mind that the earlier scenes do tend to repeat themselves and everything after that subsequently randomized. I'll try to do the best with what I can as far as the simultaneous gameplay and narration, but keep in mind that I'm awful at video games and that I can barely read. And again, for those of you watching on YouTube, you can check the links down below and you can find out where to download this fantastic game on Steam right now. It's only, you know, I think it's sale for like $2.50. So it's something cheap. Go support Spartans Vector and get yourself a great game. You can make your own wagon adventures. Good luck, have fun, everyone! They traveled in the trusty wagon, the standard, completely average, because it's the only thing that's fair. And again, I do want to remind everyone this is not going on the official Wagon Adventure document. These are just for funsies and to show off the game. Day one, they set off into the forest. We're off. Day five, seeing some animals upcoming cleaner, they hurried ahead. They needed to stock up on food for the long journey. So if you've never seen this game before, it is a... Whoa! The skunks are already out. Action-adventure game where you are a traveler trying to make it through the Old West. Posse of bandits interrupt the hunt. The game is highly, I should mention this, that the game is highly historically accurate. Great emphasis and care was brought into the design philosophy of Super Amazing Wagon Adventure. You will see very historically accurate scenes. The counter in the top right-hand corner is the hide counter, which is basically currency. Machine gun arm bandit wagon arrives. See, it's completely, whoa! It's completely 100% historically accurate. So, Panda Breaker already on 2 hearts. Hyena Bones hasn't been hit. Berserker on 3 hearts. That was close. Day 12, Berserker left the wagon to look for wild berries. I will be also yielding to Twitch chat when it becomes their turn to choose. On his way back to the wagon, Berserker noticed an entrance to a cave. He decided to investigate. Very dark inside. Online, the torch he found was filled with giant spiders. Of course, everyone loves giant spiders. Everybody loves giant spiders. All right. Zerka ran back from the cave to the wagon. Day 18, they sat around the campfire and told scary stories. Everyone's gonna get healed back up. Day 25, they reached a river crossing. Panda Breaker had the brilliant idea to try to jump over the river. Alternatively, they could go around it through, or they could ford it. So, Panda, jump or ford. And I'm going to be typing this in Twitch chat just to expedite things. And we are operating on a delay. He says ford. It made the probably wise decision to ford the river. We be fording. There were boulders in the river. Of course there were. There were a lot of boulders in the river. Something, something boulders. This is probably the second hardest one. Finally, they reached the other side of the river. Day 30, they entered in the Great Plains. Very good. And now we're really getting started. The glitch is upon us. The teacup buffaloes. Well, this is a good precedent to set for the Wagon Adventure runs here. We're going to be doing 3 tonight, by the way, before we wrap up the show. Day number scene description. Teacup buffaloes have arrived. Why do I say teacup buffaloes? Because they look like the teacup ride on the... Disney World. You all know which one I'm talking about. I don't even know how Sparse Vector was managed. I don't even know how he managed to, like, make those characters in the game. Like, the actual, like, typing characters. Come on, Berserker, stop getting hit. Day 38, they came across a fur trader. Well, our hide count isn't really all that great. Fur trader offered to trade them dinosaur eggs to replace their pistol for 51 animal hides. Yeah. I'm going to veto everyone and say no. Day 45, they heard distant gunshots. Someone might need their help. Alternatively, they could ignore the gunshots and continue on forward. Investigate or not. So it goes to the travelers, which are Panda Breaker, Berserker, and Hyena Bones. And two nopes and investigate. They ignored the gunshots and continued on. Day 50, the front wheels of the wagon fell off. Alright. Panda Breaker left the wagon to fetch the wheels. First wheel rolled into a herd of buffalo. All the buffalo. Take me home where the buffalo roam. So long as I don't get trampled to death. While on the telephone. Give me them hides! Second wheel rolled near a coyote den. Here's what I think about your coyote den. We used a nuclear bomb to kill one coyote, and Panda Breaker still managed to get hit. Panda Breaker returned back to the wagon, put the wheels back in place. Day 56, they reached another river. This one was too deep to ford. Hyena Bones had the brilliant idea to try to swim through the river. Alternatively, they could go around it through the desert path. Hyena Bones, swim, or around. She says swim, then take a deep breath, and then jumped in. They face deadly piranhas. Again, the game puts a high emphasis on realism and historical facts. You did not guess that already. Angry narwhals. Piranhas, of course, were an excellent source of hide in the Old West back in the day, especially when your wagon was traveling underwater through a river. And dodging narwhals. They landed on a small island to catch the breath. Hyena Bones noticed a supply sitting on the beach. She left the wagon to investigate. I don't think Hyena Bones has been hit yet. Hyena Bones then realized why supplies were left there. They were guarded by a flock of angry pelicans. Alright, bring it on, pelicans. You got wings and a beak, I got a shotgun. Pelicans are annoying. Hyena Bones ran back to the wagon. They quickly left the island and swam to the shore of the river. Day 62, they entered a mountain pass. Day 67, food supplies dwindled, so they hunted. AK-47, slightly better. Pack of wolves smell the blood. So far, so good. We have a lot of hides. Berserker is on one health, by the way. Should probably also mention that. Even though Panda Breaker's done most of the work. Day 70, they came across a fur trader. Speak of the devil. The fur trader offered them newer, faster wagon wheels for 97 animal hides. Sure. They traded for the newer, faster wagon wheels. We're zipping around all over the place. Day 74, turns out nearby mountain was an active volcano. Of course it was. Like I said, historical accuracy is big. They rushed ahead to avoid the approaching lava. Animals, too, ran from the lava in panic. Run, animals, run! Save the marmots! Give me hides! Wolves burning alive ran out from the lava flow. Berserker's still on one heart. Ooh, that was close. Volcanic bombs rained down from above. Oh, we missed the health. Uh-oh. I hope Berserker can drive on one heart. Then the bombardment intensified. Well. How's your micro, Berserker? Oh. Hyena Bones took one for Berserker. Thankfully, a herd of llamas sheltered them from the destruction. From some of the destruction. Thank you, llamas. Thank you. A llama chased Berserker. Berserker screamed like a little girl and then had a stroke and died. What? Berserker was killed by a llama that was supposed to be protecting us. Distracted by the carnage, they accidentally drove off a cliff. Day 80, the wagon passed through a flock of crows. So Berserker was chased by a llama, screamed like a little girl, and died of a stroke because of it. So, all right. Well, at least he died like a man. Not really. Hyena Bone's on one heart now. Oh no, at 86, the wagon fell into a spiral of light. When the lights faded, they landed on a strange trail of rock. They continued on. Strange horseless metal wagons came hurtling towards them. Hyena Bone's on one heart. Panda Breaker on three. Nope. Some men in a black and white metal wagon tried to get them to pull to the side of the trail. They suspected the men were bandits, so they continued down the trail. Like I said, historically accurate. The men in the metal wagons opened fire. We didn't do anything wrong! We didn't do anything! We were just walking here. The men had some kind of strange flying machine. Oh, Panda Breaker on two hearts. Oh, that was close. Hyena Bone's still on one heart. Oh, they're both on one heart. No, the spinning blades of the flying machine cut Panda Breaker in half. It's only Hyena Bones. But she found a rocket launcher. Hyena Bones managed to survive the attack. They decided to travel off the trail to avoid further bandits' attacks. Day 94, Hyena Bones reached the coast, and Hyena Bones wins! Thanks to a randomly placed bazooka. Hyena Bones is victorious. Soon there will be more wagons headed down the side of the trail. GG. Panda Breaker died shielding Hyena Bones from the helicopter.
Let's go, adventure.
All right. So that was that was quite the interesting wagon adventure there, especially the way that Berserker died. Oh yeah, Panda Breaker's is Hyena Bones' hero, even though I'm the one controlling it. That's good. That's typical Sinvicta luck right there. So if you'd like to play in the second of three wagon adventures, type Sparse Vector in all caps. Again, priority goes to subs and non-subs. That was definitely a strange, super amazing wagon adventure. No, you don't have to spell Sparse Vector correct, although that would help. You get brownie points if you spell Sparse Vector correct. Dun, dun, dun. Dun, 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 dun. I'm gonna let the chat catch up. Alright, so first member of the mosh pit that I saw is gonna be Ozzy Rocker. And we have to make him look somewhat like Ozzy Osbourne. There we go. That's Ozzy. Ozzy doesn't really have any facial hair. He definitely doesn't wear a cowboy hat. Yeah, sure, whatever. Second member of the mosh pit that I see is Morgan Freeman. Which barely fits. It's a fine gentleman, and we have to make him look like Morgan Freeman. Let's see. He definitely does not have Ugu eyes, and he doesn't wear glasses. And the hair color. What color hair does it? Morgan Freeman's got kind of gray hair now. Yeah, that's good enough. And last but not least, we have Lucello, also a member of the mosh pit. And Lucello has a hipster mustache. All right, so we have Ozzy Rocker, Morgan Freeman, and Lucello for the second wagon adventure run today. Good luck. Have fun, everyone. They traveled in the trusty wagon, the standard, completely average, because it's the only thing that's fair. Good luck. Have fun, everyone. Day one, they set off into the forest. Day 11, seeing some animals upcoming clearing. They hurried ahead. They need to stock up on food for the long journey. such a long journey. So it's Ozzy Rocker, Morgan Freeman, and Lucello with his hipster mustache. That would make an odd wagon. That would definitely make an odd wagon adventure. Posse of bandits interrupted the hunt. I'll be the dinosaur egg, and that is terrible. Again, keep in mind that the all historical facts that you see here are actually based on real events. For those of you who skipped history class, Sheikah Armed Bandit Wagon arrived. Day 13, Morgan Freeman left the wagon to look for wild berries. On his way back to the wagon, Morgan Freeman heard a noise in the trees. A bear wanted the berries. In its last dying breath, the bear let out a cry for help, and a swarm of rabid squirrels heard the cry, because bears can speak to squirrels. Your squirrels are no match for my flamethrower. Day 21, they reached the river crossing. Lucello had the brilliant idea to try to jump over the river, alternatively they could ford it. So, Lucello, jump or ford. And again, I'm going to be typing that in Twitch chat just to expedite things. And Lucello may or may not be paying attention. You have 2 seconds. All right. We're going to be jumping because Lucello not paying attention. They got a running start from left. They got a running start left from top of the ledge. Woo! Somehow they made it across. However, they landed in a near a den of bears, and the large thud woke the bears up. Oh man, it is going to be a bear run. What? How did that bear live? Whoa! We got some superpowered bears. Day 30, they enter to the Great Plains. And the glitch again. Oh, man. Now, I have it on good authority that Sparse Vector himself said that the glitch is supposed to be pretty rare. And we've gotten it twice in a row now. The teacup buffaloes are back. Day night number, scene description. How is Lucello getting hit so badly? So Lucello is on 2 hearts, Morgan Freeman is on 3. Ozzy Rocker is just... Ozzy is just enjoying the ride right now. Day 36, they came across a fur trader. Fur trader offered them a larger caliber pistol for 47 ammo. Yeah, I think we take that. They trade for the larger caliber pistol. We're now firing a cannon. Day 41, they passed through a Civil War battle. Like I said, historical accuracy was one of the biggest things about this game. I bring it up only because it's true. This happened. This definitely happened. I don't know what we got hit by there, but that's alright. So the cell is already on 1 heart. Ooh, health. Health. Wagon's interference in the battle decimated both Union and Confederate forces. The war was lengthened, a great loss of life. Day 42, at night, Lucello decided to look for a flower for Morgan Freeman. He'd grown fond of Morgan Freeman during his travels. Lucello brought the flower back to the camp and gave it to Morgan Freeman. Oh, I love you too, Morgan Freeman replied. The two went to the wagon to relax. Later, Lucello needed to relieve himself. So he left the camp again. It was a zombie. Switch to the lasers. Set lasers to zombie. Seems the disease has also spread to the animals. Fantastic. Super. Oh, zombie turkeys. This is good. I think Lucello is going to be fine. Luckily, Luckily, all that relaxing that he did with Morgan Freeman healed him. The power of love. Oh, until he was bitten by a zombie. Lucella couldn't believe what had happened, that he survived. Day 43, they reached another river. This one was too deep to ford. Lucello had the brilliant idea to swim underwater through the river. Alternatively, they could go around it through a desert path. So hopefully Lucello's paying attention this time. Lucello says swim. They took a deep breath and then jumped in. They faced deadly piranhas. So I'm wondering if we're gonna get this power of light again. It's very odd to get the glitch twice in a row. Angry narwhals. Well, luckily we are firing a hand cannon. Literally firing a hand cannon. Help! 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 Alright. Now, unfortunately, Unfortunately, the nukes destroy hides. And, the oxen got freaked out and swam too fast. Fantastic. The glitch gun. Alright, so this is what the glitch gun looks like. This is why it's also terrible, by the way. Giant squid blocked their path. Squid. Say cheese. Morgan Freeman left the treasure chest in the water. He swam from the wagon to investigate. He felt that there had to be something super amazing inside, but he was hesitant. Wasn't sure if he should open it. So, Morgan, open or don't. So, waiting on Morgan Freeman to decide if we want to open the chest or not. He says, open. He opened it and found an invisible pistol. What? They continued swimming on the shore of the river. Day 51, they entered a mountain pass. Day 56, they ate a great meal of marmot sliders. What is the point of an invisible pistol? Day 59, food supplies dwindled, so they hunted. So not only have we now lost the ability to see our weapon, we have now lost our caliber upgrade. So, there were a lot of llamas. Well, this is a first for me. I have never seen the invisible pistol, ever. Pack of wolves, smell the blood. So basically what we did was we just reverted back to our default weapon. But now we can't see it. But I still don't... I mean, I guess... We can still see the bullets, though, so... Day 68, they came across a fur trader. Fur trader offered them a newer, larger caliber invisible pistol for, this time, 112 animal hides. I feel like we're getting gypped. And how do we know that we're going to have a larger caliber pistol anyway? We can't see it. Day 73, the mountain pass was cold, so at night they drank to stay warm. Well, at least we got our gun back, I guess. Inebriated Ozzy Rocker left the wagon to relieve himself. How very appropriate. Fortunately, the drunken stumblings attracted the attention of a swarm of rabid squirrels. Ozzy Rocker managed to stumble into a camp. It's the wrong camp. It was a camp filled with bandits. Ozzy Rocker ran away drunkenly with the bandits chasing behind him. He made it back to the wagon. They left in a hurry. However, they were all still drunk. And oh boy, we have a drunk Ozzy who is the wagoneer. Bandits attack the wagon. It's a drunk Ozzy Rocker who is commandeered the wagon. Oh god, even the sniper rifle won't shoot straight. Or shoot on target, I should say. It never shoots straight. Alright. Day of 74, after a long night of vomiting, they felt awful and accidentally drove off a cliff. Day 83, a herd of buffalo fell off the cliff behind them. And the buffalingos are buffaling off the cliff. And who was it that pushed the herd of buffalo off the cliff? Frost Melka. People on YouTube are not going to get that. That's alright. Day 92, luckily the wagon landed in a river. The wagon, now a raft, was carried down river by the currents. Day 94, they had to avoid boulders as the wagon carefully navigated the rapids. Shotgun, not the best gun for this. It's good for the bandits, but not for rocks. Ooh, that's actually really good. Flamethrower is super good. For some reason, there are a bunch of alligators in the river. Alright. We're still okay. We've got a flamethrower. Just don't cross them. Ooh, health. Even though we don't need it. Day 96, they noticed something on the horizon. It was a bandit on a raft. Seemed the bandits had followed them and set up an ambush. Should be okay, though. Flamethrower is not the ideal situation to be in with this, Whoa! That one fired a little too quickly. Alright. I'm pulling back to go for long-range tactics right here. Now we're going back to close range. Alright. Nope. The bandits have stolen some kind of riverboat. And they get killed in less than a second. Following the attack, the river became calm. Day 99, they reached the coast. Lucello left the wagon to admire the sunset. And everybody lives! Lucello heard a noise coming from the water. The giant squid wanted the sunken treasure back. Well, he can have it, because... Yeah, finally Lucello could relax and enjoy the sunset once again. So Lucello is going to take the victory for everybody. We kept our invisible pistol somehow.
Congratulations.
Should there be more wagons heading down the trail once again, everyone? Well, not once again, but everybody survives this time. At least we had at least one person survive. So GG. We're going to go one final time here before we wrap it up. If you are watching this on YouTube and you are interested in the game, you can find a link down below that takes you straight to the Steam page. You can definitely give it a consideration for only $3. You can play this fantastic game. Support my friend Sparse Vector. So, Twitch chat, if you're watching this live, if you'd like to play, type a... Type Falcon. How about that? That would be today's passcode. Falcon. Do 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 do. I'm gonna let the Twitch chat catch up really fast. And priority does go to Twitch subs and then non-subs. Alright, so the first one that I saw is going to be Janrus. Welcome back, Janrus. Janrus is a fine gentleman, and he's got short brown hair. That sounds right. Second member of the Mosh Pit is going to be, it looks like, Luke. Jitaluke. Also known as just Luke. And he's a fine gentleman, and we have to make him look like Luke Skywalker. And He's going to look exactly like Janrus. All right. Last but not least, we have Wally Two Toes. Or just Wally Toes. He's a fine gentleman, and he's got blue hair. So, to end the celebratory episode of Super Amazing Wagon Adventure for winning the third Saturday Series SmackDown Showcase, it's going to be Janrus in the Wagoneer seat. Also joined in the middle seat by Luke, member of the Mosh Pit, and last but not least, Wally Two Toes sitting in the anchor seat with his blue hair. Good luck, have fun, everyone. Can we make it three in a row? They travel in the wagon, the standard completely average, because it's the only thing that's fair. We're off. Day one, they set off into the forest. Good luck, have fun, everybody. Day nine, sees the animals upcoming clearly. They're already ahead. They need to stock up on food for the long journey. All right. We were successful in game number two to not get hit by skunks. If you can avoid getting hit by skunks in the first scene, that is super Amazing Wagon Adventure. They saw a unicorn in the clearing. Janrus saying that he's got blonde hair, blue eyes. Unicorns seem to be leading them somewhere. On the other hand, they needed all the meat they could. Well, we all know that the unicorn never goes anywhere, so. Ain't nobody got time for unicorns. Give me that unicorn meat. Posse Band has interrupted the hunt. I have confirmation that that Sparse Vector says the unicorn usually never takes you anywhere desirable. And we have had a unicorn ambush completely wipe out an entire party in one of the adventures. So we're not gonna be going to evolve in that one. Some of the bandits can actually aim. Oh boy, the bandits have brought their tryhard hats out. Yeah, we have a sniper rifle too. Take that, bandits. Oh, first blood. Day 18, Janrus left the wagon and found some edible mushrooms. So Janrus takes first blood. Get rid of these sniper rounds. Janrus ate one of the mushrooms on his way back to the wagon. He felt sort of funny, easy for me to read. Janrus battled his inner demons. Looks like dead fish. Or Technicolor. Oh, the jukes. Oh, the jukes are real. Painful memories bounce around in his head. Ooh, looks like a hit there. Hours later, Janrus returned to reality after nuking his painful memories. Day 20, they reach a river. Luke had the brilliant idea to try to jump over the river. Alternatively, they could ford it. So I'm going to be typing it in chat. Luke, jump or ford? Are we jumping or are we be fording? He says ford. They made the probably wise decision to ford the river. Before there were boulders in the river. I don't want to risk it. There were a lot of boulders in the river. Janrus saying go me. Yeah, it was all you, Janrus. Something boulders. Everyone gets to live vicariously through my micro. It's all right. That's what's so fun about the show. Finally, they reached the other side of the river. Day 28, they entered into the Great Plains. Day 31, they came across an area with plentiful good grass. The oxen feasted. The oxen seem to move more quickly after eating well. They are moving much more quickly. Day 41, Janrus got the measles. Well, this is not the scene that you want to be entering in with one heart. We already know that. Day 44, they came across a large herd of buffalo. Oh boy, and we have the uncontrollable wagon right now. Things not looking good for Janrus. Things are not looking good for Janrus. Day 53, buffalo. All right. is the worst scene to... Oh, that was close. We should have taken a hit there. I don't know how we didn't. Come on, Janders. You want to live. You may think that speed... Oh, health. Yes. All right, Janders is going to be okay now. Day 54, some angry buffalo charge the wagon. Day 59, Janders recover from the measles. Very nice. Day 61, they came across a fur trader. Well, luckily we have a ton of hides now. Fur trader offered them supplies to chase for animal hides. Well, we don't need anything, so... Day 69, they noticed an injured falcon to the side of the trail, and animal lover Wally Two Toes decided to help the falcon! Coyotes wanted to eat the injured falcon. Alright, Wally, don't screw this up. Don't screw this up, Wally. Come on, Wally, you can do it. Oh, health. No! Day 77, after recovering from his injuries. The falcon was a useful hunting partner. We've got the falcon. Falcon OP, says you and me. And things just got a lot easier. Impressed by its abilities, they decided to carry the falcon with them. 86, the wagon axle broke and the wagon was stuck. Luke left the wagon to walk to the nearest trading post miles away. Oh man, this is the worst one for the falcon too. 87, coyotes hounded him. The falcon's good, but it's not good at close range. Ooh, that's actually going to help out a lot. Flamethrower, all right, thank you, falcon. Day 88, Luke stumbled upon a camp of sleeping travelers. Luke noticed that the travelers had left supplies sitting out in the camp. He was tempted to steal the supplies. So, Luke, steal... Or don't. And I'm going to be typing that in Twitch chat just to speed things up. He says, steal. Luke decided to steal the supplies. And apparently murder them. He felt no remorse for stealing the supplies, murdering the travelers in cold blood. Day 91, finally he reached the trading post. Replacement axle cost all of Luke's money, then he had to travel back. And here comes the traveling backing. And Luke went to the dark side. Whoa, that's the reason why. Falcon's not good. It's not good in close quarters. Day 92, Luke was haunted by the spirits of the travelers he murdered. If only he hadn't murdered those people for no reason. In 95, Luke reached the wagon. After repairing the wagon, they traveled onward. Day 102, they reached a river. This one was too deep to ford. Luke had the brilliant idea to swim underwater through the river. Alternatively, they'd go around it through a desert path. So Luke, again, swim or around. Luke saying they were just Jawas. I don't know about that. They looked like people to me, Luke. He says, go around. They made the probably wise decision to take the desert path around the river. Day 107, they entered the Great Plains. They entered the desert. Day 108, they came across a gambling cowboy. Cowboy bet them all their animal hides that they couldn't kill 20 quails in 15 seconds. I think we've got the falcon. They accepted the bet, and Luke was ready. All right, falcon and Luke, do us proud. Do proud, falcon. Oh. No, they lost the bet and paid all their animal hides. Oh, we were one away, two or one away, something like that. That's why the falcon is not the best sometimes. Day 112, they had to avoid venomous snakes. So Wally Two Toes on one heart. Ooh, help. He's on two hearts now. Well, luckily we don't need hides anymore, I guess. In 121, the man-eating giant scorpions are even more deadly. Bring on, scorpions. Your claws and stingers are no match for our bullets. Unless when they get through the bullets. Oh no, we got the falcon! Alright, falcon trying to save us. Day 122, they noticed some kind of ancient ruin to the side of the trail. Luke decided to investigate. Luke doing everything. It was very dark inside. Upon lighting the torch, he found it was filled with giant venom-spinning cobras. I think we're going to be okay. He ran back from the ruins to the wagon. Day 128, they entered the mountain pass. They are giant scorpions. They're about the size of the buffalo. Day 133, food supplies were dwindling, so they hunted. I don't know about you, but the scorpions that I've seen are not almost the size of the oxen that carries our wagons. I think if they were, I think humans would be slightly further down the food chain. Pack of wolves smell the blood. Just getting rid of the charge of the laser because I want to be able to get the hides. Good kill there, Falcon. Oh, missed that one. Everyone on two hearts. Whoa, Falcon! Day 142, they came around as a fur trader. Falcon completely whiffed on that one. Fur trader offered to trade them a slightly more aggressively trained Falcon for 100 animal hides. Unfortunately, they didn't have enough. Day 145, a snowstorm began. The wolves were relentless even during the snowstorm. Oh boy. Wally Two Toes on one heart. The Falcon does not always equal guaranteed win. You get enough of the scenes that you have to go close range with it. The side of the trail, they saw a dark figure. Luke left the wagon to investigate. Why is Luke doing everything? Turns out it was Bigfoot, and Bigfoot was mad. You can be mad all you want, Bigfoot. We got a Falcon. Luke ran back to the wagon. They left in a hurry, and they accidentally drove off a cliff. Luke has, I think, done everything in this game. Day 150, some eagles attack the wagon. Bring it on, eagles, we got a falcon. Who would win in the fight, an eagle or a falcon? Pretty sure the eagle would win. Hands down. Whoa, everyone on one heart. No, an eagle grabbed Luke, taking him soaring through the air. He thought about America, then the eagle dropped him and he died. Oh, man. Day 157, luckily the wagon landed in the river. The wagon now wrapped is carried down over the current. So Luke did pretty much everything and then died for it. Day 160, they had to avoid boulders as the wagon carefully navigated the rapids. Well, at least Luke was thinking about America before he died. Soaring through the air after the eagle dropped him. All right. Janrus, I'm pretty sure, has not done anything except the mushrooms. For some reason, there's a bunch of alligators in the river. We still have everyone on one heart, by the way. Oh, come on, Falcon. You can't miss. Come on, Falcon. Health. And it went to Janrus. No, an alligator killed Wally Two Toes. Wally, why? Now it's down to Janrus. We will not be feeding the alligators. Day 162, Janrus knows something on the horizon. It was abandoned on the raft. Seems the bandits had followed him and set up an ambush. Wally did find the falcon, that's true. But again, that might be a blessing in disguise. Or a curse in disguise, depending on how you look at it. Alright. Ooh. Health! Alright, Janrus, he can do it. Don't break our streak, Janrus. Don't break our streak, Janrus. Janrus, you're breaking our streak! No! Janrus died a slow, lingering death after a bullet punctured his stomach. Oh, the journey ended there. The bandits looted the remains of the wagon and left the rest to sink. GG! Well, Janrus is the final survivor, but unfortunately, it was just too late. Too late. So congratulations to Super Amazing Wagon Adventure for winning the third ever Saturday Series SmackDown. Very nice indeed. Congrats. Thank you, everyone who tuned in to vote. Thank you all for watching here on YouTube. And don't forget to check my social media next week for the upcoming matchup. It's going to be released Monday or Tuesday, depending on... just depending. Thank you for watching, everyone. Hope you enjoyed it, and we'll see you next time here on the channel. So long, everybody. All right, and for those of you watching live, I'm going to run a block of commercials and wrap it up. Thank you for watching, everyone. Thank you, everyone who voted, and we will be seeing you Wednesday. Again, as a reminder, I will not be doing Sunday streams anymore. So enjoy your weekend and go watch some football. And I'll see you all, if not sooner than later, definitely on Wednesday. Thank you all for tuning in. Do appreciate it. Good night, everybody!